Not bad, huh?
Yeah, not bad. I'm impressed.
Pretty good for a
46-year-old.
I'm more impressed with that putting stroke at his age. That's awesome.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Smooth.
Left center, a little draw, continuing to hook.
Well, that left side's a lot better than that right side today, Bob.
So they're all in good shape on this seventh hole worth $25,000. We'll be back after this.
I want you to take a look at the leaderboard. The who's who in small trucks. Toyota. Toyota's the one who's got gas turbo truck power. I guess he's playing through. And Toyota's the one that's got more hauling and pulling power. Bang! You know who's got room to carry the big load? Toyota. So it's pretty clear to me that the who's who knows what's what in trucks. Who could ask for anything more? Toyota.
In recent years, over 100 companies closed their doors and left town. Big companies like BorgWarner and International Rectifier moved to Rancho, California, where unusual things happened. As soon as employees moved in, they wanted to get out. Some went to court, others headed for the hills, while management took to playing around at lunch. But in the end, everyone came to the same conclusion. Rancho, California is a great place to take your vocation.
I'm Jimmy Connors, and it's about time you met my partner, my financial side.
All successful people and companies have a financial side.
Let's go, partner.
But to really be a winning team, you might need some help.
We need some help.
You need Bain Weber behind you for financial expertise, sound advice. We believe the quality of life just might depend on the quality of your financial services.
Thank you, Bain Weber.
You're welcome. You're awfully stiff. You've got to loosen up a little bit.
Introducing the 1986 front-wheel drive family Camry from Toyota. The car that gives you more. More headroom than any other compact, and more hip room and leg room than many compact cars. That means the family Camry has more room for a rock group or a group of rocks. The town council of Slezak, Michigan, with the mayor's dog thrown in, 42 gas balloons, two sets of identical twins, plus a man named Murray. The family Camry from Toyota.
Who could ask for anything more?
Relive the magic of the World Professional Figure Skating Championships on a special NBC Sports World Encore next Saturday.
A happy and very relieved Arnold Palmer, who had a lot to put on the line since he was shut out in skins last year and blew a one-foot par putt on the first hole. He has rebounded nicely. He won $30,000 on the fourth hole with a carryover, and then with his birdie putt at six, he picked up another $15,000.
The pin today is cut on the right side of this green, which is shaped in a horseshoe design. This is really a fun green. If you miss this ball anywhere left, you're going to have some real trouble. Arnold's just barely in the left rough, 164 yards to the green, probably hitting around a six or
what
a seven iron.
Fellas, how about bringing that sign on this side, please?
22.
Thank you.
This is Arnold Palmer's second shot with a 7-iron from the left edge of the fairway. Good angle into the pin. The pin is tucked in that right neck of this green. A treacherous green. Tough to get close.
No, I pulled it.
He pulled a little bit and it's hooking, but it's still not going to be a bad shot if it carries far enough. It's a pretty good golf shot. Yeah, Arnold's all of a sudden, his standards are real high, Vinny.
That's right. Those new irons have gotten where he doesn't cozy it up. He feels disappointed.
Well, Vinny, we just said to you, all of a sudden you said you pulled it. Your standards are pretty high all of a sudden.
Hey, Bobby, these irons are making them get a little higher. I've hit some pretty good ones. I'm pleased.
Good.
He's a lot bolder, isn't he, Bob?
He sure is a little older. I was a little too close to Fuzzy right there, and he's hitting a pitching wedge from about 120 yards, and he pulled it to the left. He's going to have to hurry. Yeah, it did carry that bunker. Jack had driven the ball perfect right in the middle of the fairway. Jack Nicklaus is going to hit next with a 9-iron.
Not too much.
Got a little helping wind, pin on the front part of the green.
When Nicholas designed this hole, it's 445 yards. He knew that the prevailing wind was behind you. So he went ahead and put a little extra length on this green and put a tough green here. So he knew you'd be going in with a short iron.
Check with the 9-iron. It is right in line with the flag. Now it's drifting slightly right. Ooh, it didn't carry far enough.
Lost it.
Caught it thin.
No, I didn't quite catch it right, Jackson. I had a little 8-iron and just didn't quite hit it. Hard enough.
A wedge. 26 and...
Zeller on the green. Palmer is on the green.
Like this club?
Nicholas in the rough.
Tom Watson used to situations like this. Getting a flying wedge out of the rough. 140 yards.
Get a hair right.
Oh, it is.
Good shot.
Well, we have a little time, so let's spend it with the irrepressible Mr. Fuzzy Zeller. Playing with a Palmer, a Nicholas who has that look of eagles, that will not intimidate your personality, or will it? Do they mind it if you start to talk and laugh?
Well, I hope not, because they're going to hear it. I'll be very honest with you. I think Jack probably 6 or 7 years ago would have minded. But he has mellowed. Arnold has been Arnold. Arnold's probably the toughest to play with of the three.
Why?
I think it's the people who follow Arnold Palmer. Now, Jack is very easy to play with. He does talk. I mean, even though the people on TV don't see him doing that, he chatters an awful lot out there, and so does Tom. But I think Arnold, just being Arnold Palmer and the people around who follow Arnold Palmer, he's probably the toughest individual to play with.
You are, in a sense, the new kid on the block. Jack, Arnold, and Tom were in the beginning of Skins. This is their third time around. You suddenly have burst upon the scene as far as Skins is concerned. How do you feel about that?
Well, first of all, I feel wonderful just for the opportunity to be in the category to be selected. And I really can't tell you. I mean, a little boy from Indiana like I am, having the chance to play with these three great superstars in a game of Skins. It's a sudden death play, and I can't say enough. I'm overjoyed just to have the opportunity to play with him.
And he'll be even happier if he gets his first skin. He's the only one shut out up to here.
Hold on.
Jack Nicklaus hit that 8-iron short in the rough, so he's away.
Yes, Jack with a pitching wedge from just short of the green, up slope lie. Not a difficult shot. He has about 10 feet of rough and apron to carry, and then about 18 feet of green. Broke loose a little more.
Left.
Is it mine?
Yeah, I didn't think it would roll that direction.
Bob Fuzzy made a good point there in that interview that the public doesn't think that Nicholas talks much, but you can tell by listening to the telecast today that he talks quite a bit, not only to his fellow players, but to his caddy as well.
And to himself.
That's right.
Now we have moved into somewhat of the high rent district at $25,000 a hole, and the players would appear to have quieted down considerably.
A little bit right, not a whole
lot. That seems to be the way it goes.
You like it more?
In the beginning, I think it's going to break.
In here? Okay. Yes. No, I can see it. I can see it fine. Yeah, it's going to break in the beginning. You're right.
Tom's caddy is Bruce Edwards, and Tom relies quite a bit on Bruce for reading the greens, the speed, the grain, the slope. It's always better to have two heads than one.
Yeah.
He's not happy with that, I know.
Zeller with an effort that could be a birdie and his first skin of the day. Arnold Palmer, you remember, pulled a 7-iron, but on the green.
Fuzzy's got to get something going here. We're almost to the end of the 9 holes. This just might be it.
Oh, what a tough miss.
Is that good? It's only a half a foot.
And as Arnold said, yeah, it's good with me, because Arnold is still putting for birdie. We have a moment to remind good folks that all the amateurs and the pro-am received a set of Callaway hickory sticks named in honor of Bob Jones, the greatest amateur golfer of all time.
Sure does. Jack, I can see you back there.
I think that's probably one of Arnold's charter jets running around upstairs.
He gets out of there.
There it goes.
No money, honey. You kidding?
That's a pretty fair putt there.
Want to mark it?
I'm going to try to hit it in.
The Arnold winds up with a par. Boy, he'll never come any closer to a $25,000 skin.
It's incredible to see the change. Here it is again in Arnold. Almost making it just over the left lip. Look at the look in his face. A throwback to the years gone by when he used to knock those in all the time.
Uh-oh. Though Nicklaus can't par the hole, Palmer is still alive to win the skin. It's up to Watson and or Zeller to catch him.
Again, that's what happens in skins. Jack just gave that one away. If he had tried to knock it in, it would have taken the pressure off these guys. These are no gimmies.
Okay, it becomes a carryover, and that really gets your attention to the eighth hole.
What do you do?
The eighth hole will now be worth $50,000. So we should have a good long look at it. A $50,000 skin coming up.
The eighth hole is 171-yard par 3, but because of the prevailing wind, it plays much shorter than that. The players will be playing a 7 or an 8 iron to an hourglass-shaped green. You want to avoid the collection bunker that you see right here on the left side. The pin is cut in the back left of the green, and I think you'll see a birdie here.
The last skin was picked up on the sixth hole. It was won by Arnold Palmer.
I got you, Ben.
Palmer and Zeller par 7, so Arnold still has the honor.
No, if I don't sink, you're safe.
Palmer with 3 skins, Watson with 2, Nicklaus winning his skin on the first hole, and Fuzzy Zeller still on the outside looking in.
Blind squirrel finds an acorn, everyone.
How are we doing? One time? Time to play with?
Tell him I'm on the green, not the tee.
Okay, Bob, can you tell us anything particular about that green while we have a moment?
Well, yes, it has a big swale in the center, and anything left center in the middle of the green is going to kick to that bunker. The pin today is tucked way in the left rear, about 15 feet over the crown or the hump, and then there's a flat putting surface to the back. A lot of wind behind the players today, so if they clear that hump and get towards the pin, they're liable to go to the back fringe. Playing about 171 yards today.
There's a picture of Arnold's new Axiom irons. The difference on these irons is that the face, the scoring of the face and the paint on the club face helps to bring the club more on an inside path. At least that's what Arnold said.
A good-looking shot.
Yeah.
He just passed the hole and stopped dead, about 12 feet behind the hole. Good shot by Arnold.
Those irons work. Tom Watson with the 6-iron.
Starting to the right, drawing a little bit. It's going to be a good golf shot. About hole high, about 15 feet to the right. Peter, the greens are very flat, or this particular green is very flat where the pin is placed.
Think so, Jackson?
It's pretty treacherous if you leave it short.
That big hump and swale will draw it right back into the bunker. To the right, it's going to have to hurry. It did clear that hump, and it's about 20 feet short into the right.
It's all right, everybody.
Shot.
Boy, that's a good-looking shot. If it carries that hump, oh, boy. About 8 feet away for Fuzzy.
Thank you.
So, Fuzzy Zeller, perhaps 8 feet away from his first skin, which is worth $50,000, and Arnold Palmer thinks of the skin that got away.
Protecting what you value is the smartest policy, and your family's best protection comes from USF&G.
For generations of Americans, protecting home, auto, and life has meant USF&G insurance. Just ask your independent agent.
We got you covered, America, covered from day to day. USF&G covers the USA.
The armor plating that protects many tanks is made with titanium. An element that's twice as strong as steel, yet half the weight. That's why Citizen uses titanium for this watch. While anyone can make a tank watch, we make a watch that's built like a tank. From the Citizen Collection, the smartest engineering ever strapped to a wrist.
Hi, I'm Mr. Taylor. My secretary made a reservation.
Yes, she requested a Camaro.
A Camaro? I'm afraid that's a bit much.
It's only $35.95 a day. Fun to drive.
Well,
$35.95 a day on weekdays for a Camaro from National, and only $24.95 a day on weekends. So why rent just a car when you can rent some wheels?
There it is.
Hey, thanks.
You deserve National attention.
All right.
Out here, it's me alone against the course. But in the financial world, you need all the help you can get. You need the Payne Webber army behind you.
Even golf legends can use some financial backup. Payne Webber is ready to roll, putting all its resources at your command.
We believe the quality of life just might depend on the quality of your financial services.
Thank you, Payne Webber. Now that's the kind of army you want behind you.
The Heisman Trophy. For half a century, it has symbolized excellence in collegiate football. Its recipients, an honor roll of distinguished athletes, men of outstanding personal achievement. Live from New York, the 51st presentation of the Heisman Trophy. If it's special, it's on NBC Sports.
We have $50,000 putts coming up. Jack Nicklaus is away about 20 feet right and short of the flagsticks. Tom Watson is 15 feet right of the pin. Arnold Palmer is 12 feet past the hole. And here is Fuzzy Zeller with reason to smile. A great shot.
Boy, that's a good-looking shot. If it carries that hump, oh, boy. About 8 feet away for Fuzzy.
Thank you. Yeah, just that side.
Remember, this is a $50,000 hole. If we have a tie, it would make the ninth hole worth $75,000.
These guys must be used to that big money. I certainly am not. They're so relaxed.
Get it! Get in there! Get it!
Jack just missing. Remember on six when it lipped out.
Good putt.
We've seen a lot of these putts go right on the edge, just slip by. Again, the greens are perfect. They're a little soft, but they're rolling very true.
All right, Nicklaus with his par. Now we'll see.
I got three of them with a free run.
Watson, Palmer, and then Zeller. And again, a reminder, one tie, all tie.
Yeah, almost straight.
The problem is with Jack going first is he can't be that careless. He's got to try to make it, but at least ensure his par. Now he's sitting there with a par, and these other three guys have free shots at it, free rolls at it. So that's uncomfortable for Jack.
The Watson from 15 feet, a birdie putt. That could be worth $50,000. Now it's up to Zeller and Palmer to catch him and have the hole. Take another look at that.
Don't wait on me.
It seemed to stop, take a look at the hole, and then go in.
Don't wait on me.
It almost didn't want to go in. It wanted to add to the drama. Boom!
Great.
He's the best, without a doubt. He and Craig Stadler are the two best putters on tour. Of course, Arnold Palmer's done pretty good today, too.
I think it's good enough for a tie, is what I think it is.
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta believe.
Like the Royal.
Watson right? Thinking that Palmer or Zeller will knock it in to tie him. We'll see.
Now, this is interesting. Arnold's been having some free runs at it all day. Now he's got some pressure on him. He's got to make this to tie.
Yep. What a putt. So Arnold Palmer from 12 feet gets a hug from Fuzzy Zeller. And that means we have a $50,000 carryover to the ninth hole. And Watson just had $50,000 lifted out of the wallet, at least for the moment.
Tom does not like that. I know that for sure.
So the ninth hole is going to get your attention. It's worth $75,000.
The ninth hole at Bear Creek is a 552-yard par 5. And if the prevailing wind is blowing, this hole can definitely be reached in two. Your drive must carry this wash area that you see here, preferably down the left side of the fairway, which gives you the best angle of approach to this green. You want to avoid that fairway bunker that you see there on the left. If you must lay up, you've got to do so with a middle to a long iron, leaving you just a wedge to the pin, which is cut on the right side of the green today. This reminds me a lot of St. Andrews in that it's a double green that shares with the 12th hole. If you do get home in two, though, it's such a large green that it's not that difficult to three-putt.
Let's go back and take another look at that 12-footer. It tied Watson. It took the heat off Zeller. Fuzzy didn't have to look over that 8-footer to get even. So now Palmer, who has the last skin on 6, has the honor again.
Arnold's going to be letting out shaft here. You've got to hit two big ones to get home in two.
Hang on. Hang on.
He did just that.
Go, ball.
That's perfect on the left side. As I said earlier, the key to Arnold playing well is having the honors. He doesn't have to look at anybody else hit because in Arnold's world, he's the only one alive.
That was a good drive. It's in perfect spot to try to reach it in two, and he's downwind. He can get home in two.
No.
Watson said nope.
Ah!
is to the left side. It missed the bunker. It is in the rough, and it's not bad. He can actually reach the green from there, too, Peter. He's in the rough, but it'll hit a little flyer downwind. So, hole's playing shorter than normal because the wind is picked up about 15 mile an hour at this time. They're favoring that left side, Peter, because that wash on the right, you can't make a birdie from the right. Check down the left center. Working back. And I mean long. He has outdriven Arnold about 45 yards and Watson about 40 yards.
Wow, that is long. Look at that drive.
Tremendous drive.
Probably put a little angry on it, considering the sixth and the eighth holes.
I imagine there's a little anger right here as well.
Fuzzy down the left side. He's going to have to be careful. Didn't catch. He bounced into that sand bunker on the left side.
Luscious feeling.
That bunker there is no fun.
I mean, I've been there. I guarantee it would have probably gotten...
So Palmer on the left side. Watson on the left side in the slight rough. Nicklaus a tremendous drive, and Zeller in the sand bunker. We'll be back.
Who gives you more for less? Toyota is who. Chrome front bumper. Split bench seat. AM, FM, stereo, and cassette. Buy any of these new Toyota trucks and you can get up to $1,000 worth of added features for only $399. So get more for less and save up to $630. Look for the more for less sticker at your Toyota dealer and get more for less.
Who could ask for anything more Toyota?
Protecting what you value is the smartest policy. And your family's best protection comes from USF&G.
For generations of Americans, protecting home, auto, and life has meant USF&G insurance. Just ask your independent agent.
We got you covered, America, covered from day to day. USF&G covers the USA.
When do you say LA?
It's time to start your chestnuts roasting. Deck those halls and otherwise prepare to party. Tis the season to stock up on beer. Some of that beer is going to be L.A. from Anheuser-Busch. L.A. tastes great, and it's got half the alcohol. During a long party, that's a choice my friends like to have. And they do like to have fun.
Is that mistletoe?
I hope so.
L.A., sometimes it's the perfect thing to say.
Who gives you more? Toyota, that's who. More models than any other import car.
Who could ask for anything more?
More high-performance 16-valve engines in more models than any other company. All with time-tested Toyota reliability.
No mechanics in a panic. We keep running year to year.
More fun, more quality, and more for your money.
Who could ask for anything more? Toyota.
The NFL plays here when the Browns battle the Giants.
Before your team takes the field, our team hits the air. NFL 85.
Fuzzy Zeller, hugging Arnold Palmer, knocked in that putt at 8 to halve the hole, but now they move to 9 with good reason to hug and $75,000 waiting for the winner. Let's go to Bob Golby and Jack Nicklaus.
Jack, that was a tremendous drive. I know you're not happy with some of those putts that have been sliding by, but you really let out the shaft on that one.
Yeah, hit it good, Bob. This kind of hole that you have to really just sort of work it off the side of the hill and keep it out of the brank on the right, and I did hit a good solid shot.
You know, Jack, I had the opportunity to play your course yesterday for the first time, and after playing golf for 48 years, I could honestly say this might be the best golf course I ever play. It's fair, it's tough, but it's a real test of golf.
Well, I appreciate that, Bob. Thank you. We've tried to build a golf course that the people here at Bear Creek could play, but also one that could test the guys like on a day like today. And you're going to make a lot of birdies out here, but you're also going to make some bogeys.
Or double bogeys. Good luck, Jack.
Thanks, Bob.
Well, while Jack was talking to Bob Golby, we saw Fuzzy Zeller come out of that sand bunker short of the green. It's a par 5, so he's in good position. Now we'll take a look at Tom Watson. Went on the left side of the fairway in slight rough.
Tom Watson's drive just cleared that bunker that you see that Fuzzy was in.
Flags move a little bit, please.
Arnold's the next hitter.
Can someone do that?
How far is he, Bob?
Arnold's about 260 to the hole.
Try to go right over that.
He has to carry the ball that far, too, because that bunker guards that pin on the right-hand side. He may kind of come in there left to right through the opening. 3 wood for Arnold. Little helping wind, and he started in the opening. It's drawing a little bit. It is straightening out, but it's going to have to hang on. It doesn't go in that back bunker. He got a nice kick, though.
It's on the green, Bob. He's got a long putt for eagle.
I pulled it a little, Buzz.
Still putting.
Yeah, that's the good news.
Tom lost it a little bit to the right. He's pushed it out to the right towards the gallery.
Go all the way down.
That ball is still rolling into the hazard, Bob. One of the reasons Jack Nicklaus has been so great over the years is that he swings within himself. He always swings about three-quarter speed, and when he comes to a golf hole like this, he reaches back and he goes 100%, and that's why he hits it 50 yards by these other guys. He's one of the most powerful players in the game, but he plays with so much control. That's why he's number one. It's interesting. 7 wins in 1 year, 1972 and 73. Nobody wins 7 golf tournaments in 1 year anymore. I don't know why, but nobody seems to dominate anymore.
Good one.
Jack Nicklaus with a 4-iron, you heard him say.
He's on the green. Remember now, this ninth hole is worth $75,000. We have a moment. Earlier, we spent some time with Tom Watson. Was there a time when Tom Watson was out on the golf course in a tournament and suddenly said to himself, I belong here?
Yeah, I think so. I think in 1977... Finally, when I'd broken through and I won a couple major championships and I was playing the best I'd ever played, I said to myself, I believe I've attained a certain level by which I can play the game. And I've surpassed my expectations, and that with a lot of hard work, I'll be able to maintain and improve that level. 77 was the year.
The better you get, the more pressure there is for you to excel, at least from the fan. He now comes to see Tom Watson win. Do you feel extra pressure now because you are Tom Watson to excel?
Yes, you do. I think any player who becomes a success feels that extra pressure. Along with that extra pressure, is an increase of responsibilities to things besides golf. First of all, I have a family. Young family, and that's a responsibility that I have to learn how to deal with as far as managing my time, and they come first. Second of all, is my career and making sure that is maintained. I have probably, at the expense of my career, I've spent more time with my family, and as a result, I'm not using it as an excuse, but I find that my level of ability has decreased in this last couple of years because I haven't managed my time very well. I haven't practiced as much, and that's something that you have to do. And I look at players, especially Jack Nicklaus, who is a great organizer of time. I'm not a good organizer of time. It'd take me an hour to organize something that Jack could take 10 minutes to organize. And that's something that it's a learning process that I'm doing right now.
Well, the learning process continues for all of us. Tom Watson won his last skin on the fifth hole, had one taken right out of his hand when Arnold Palmer putt tied him. So this hole is worth $75,000.
Thank you. Take your picture now. Take your picture now. Go on. Go on.
Bob, it looked to me like Tom Watson hit his second shot into the hazard to the right.
Yes, he is in the hazard, but it's not a bad lie. Only thing he has is a little depression from when they seeded the grass. It was sort of a ridge, and he's in one of those ridges. Not the best lie, but he has a little bit of green to work with. Not very good, but he's to the fringe about 3 feet short of the green.
Through,
guys,
come on now. I just want to make sure you guys got drunk.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Yeah, hold it.
The last skin was garnered on the sixth hole with Arnold Palmer's birdie. The seventh hole, Zeller and Palmer tied. The eighth hole, Watson and Palmer tied. So the ninth hole with the carryover, $75,000. If we don't have an outright winner, we would then start tomorrow on the tenth hole. It could be worth $100,000.
This is a spectacular green. This is a double green that is shared with the 12th green. And you can see how long a putt this is. This is an incredibly huge green.
He's about 95 feet, Peter, and he has to negotiate that knob in the center of his putt about 40 feet from him. It could break either way if he misses the top of that knob. Well, he's hit a good solid looking putt. From 95 feet, that's fantastic.
Look at that look on his face. He's confident, isn't he? Thank you. I think you better mark it.
I'm sure he will, Peter.
I think Arnold Palmer feels like he's on top of the world right now. I know the last 2 years he was embarrassed. He wasn't happy with the way he's played. But today, he's come back. Now, this is Jack Nicklaus putting for an eagle, and this puts a little pressure on Jack. Not only does he have a chance to make the eagle, but he's got to hit a good putt and leave it close, if he does miss it, for that birdie putt.
About 75 feet, Peter.
You notice Jack has been doing a little talking earlier, but now he's all business for $75,000. He's the best, right?
That's
there.
That's the third putt that Nicklaus has just missed making. On the sixth, again at the eighth, and now at the ninth.
That's a 75-footer.
Well, it looks like tomorrow is going to be a $100,000 hole now that Nicklaus and Palmer are so close. Let's take another look at a 75-foot ride towards $75,000. Watson trying to chip in for birdie.
All the pressure was off.
So he has wrapped it up now. He'll pick up.
I believe Fuzzy Zeller still has about 15 feet for birdie himself.
Don't wait. Go knock it in.
I'm going to line her up. I love it. Oh, I'll try for it. All right. I'll give my best shot at it.
Poor Fuzzy hasn't played that bad today, yet he's only been the supporting cast.
Well, I said I was going to get a nice putt.
Well, as it's been since the early 60s, the big prize is sitting there, and again, it's Nicholas and Palmer head-to-head.
It's a great story.
All right. Palmer gets the birdie, so it is up to Jack Nicklaus to get his birdie, prevent the skin from being caught by Palmer. And that would mean tomorrow the 10th hole would be worth $100,000. Not a bad opening act.
Yeah, you can make it.
Turn around and ask a question. They got nobody there, huh?
So Nicholas does it to Palmer. They each birdie the ninth, and that means no skin. And what a carryover. We open up tomorrow in the 10th hole for $100,000.
I thought you said you couldn't putt.
We will be back to talk to all four of the competitors and continue the ongoing story of skins after this.
Who's ready to unleash the most powerful small 4x4 ever to beat up a mountain? Who's ready to unchain more horsepower than any small 4x4 ever? Who's introducing the first 4x4 gas turbo in America? Toyota's who? The 1986 Toyota 4x4 Turbo. With all-new high-track independent front suspension for even more comfort. It's the who's who in 4x4s.
Who could ask for anything more? Toyota!
First FootJoy started a revolution with stay-soft golf gloves that play through heat and wet. Still look like this, not this. Now there are many trying to copy the stay-soft glove, but FootJoy has made new and improved stay-soft using a better Cabretta leather from Petards, and only FootJoy has it. Leather that's 30% more moisture repellent, much tackier, grips better, dries faster, stays softer, even longer. New and improved stay-soft. We made the best even better.
Hearing this for
you? You can see the leaderboard. Arnold Palmer winning three skins for $45,000, Watson two at 30, Nicholas for $15,000, and Zeller shut out today. Interesting point, Palmer finished with a rush. He birdied four of the last six holes. However, he didn't get that much of a payoff. He needed a birdie to have a hole with Watson at eight, and of course his birdie putt at nine, he was caught by Nicholas putt. That means number 10 tomorrow will be worth $100,000. Let's join the players and go to Bob Golby.
Well, I'm down here with all these four great champions. And Arnold, you made four birdies the last six holes, and the 10th hole tomorrow is going to be for $100,000.
Ooh, that's a lot, Bob. I don't know. I got to get that putting stroke fortified tonight.
That little short putt on the first hole may have loosened you up and helped you make those birdies?
Well, I don't know, Bob. I certainly was a little shook by missing that putt. You know, Jack's okay, but I didn't want to hand him $15,000 just like that.
Not that good a friend, right? Fuzzy, I know you didn't play quite as well as you'd like, but you played well. I thought you just didn't make the birdies.
Well, that's the thing. You got to make birdies in this game. I didn't make a birdie on the front nine, so maybe tomorrow I might have four or five in me. Who knows?
You're waiting for the big money, right?
Yeah, well, I'm still young yet, you know. That's what I'm waiting on. I wish I could say that, Bob.
You're 22 years younger than Arnold? Is that what you said?
Oh, now, I don't know if I'm 22. It's pretty close. I'm 34.
That's enough.
Good luck tomorrow, Fuzzy. Tom, last year you won, what, $70,000 on the front nine?
I won all the skins in the front side. That was fun. It's a little bit different this year with Arnold making all those putts, Arnold.
Thanks, Tom.
I'm learning something from you today.
Of course, now, last year you started out great the front nine. This year you didn't make quite as many birdies, but the big money's again on the back, isn't it, tomorrow?
Well, I made a couple skins. As Jack said, we've all played, we played well. We had a lot of skins out. We didn't really come down where there were a lot of carryovers, but now the big money comes. There are three carryovers, and you're going to see some different putts out there tomorrow.
I thought there was a lot of good putts this morning that didn't really go in the cup. They just slid by. The greens are beautiful, and they're fast.
The greens are great, and you can if you get the ball in line, you are going to make the putt here because they're so smooth.
Well, I think you're swinging great for coming out of Kansas City in that cold weather.
Hey, I'm just, I was over in Japan and Australia playing over there in some great golf courses, and after the Royals won the World Series, that's getting me pumped up for this thing.
Well, good luck tomorrow, Tom.
All right.
Jack, course that Jack built. You played well. That was a tremendous drive, as we mentioned earlier, on the 18th hole. I know you like your game. You change it going back to left or right. Is that right?
Well, I did at the end of last summer, Bob. I don't hit the ball quite as far doing that, although the tee shot the last hole was a long one. But it's the way I've played all my life. And near the end of the year, I played well at Milwaukee and had a chance to win. And I think it's my way to play golf. I've tried to play the other way, and I just got too inconsistent. So I kind of like the way I'm hitting the ball, and I just got to make more putts just like these other guys. You know, Arnie and I have played for years.
You made that putt back here. My Lord, you lift the hole.
Almost.
You lift it from 80 feet.
Jack, nobody feels sorry about you putting because you made a lot of them over the years.
Yeah, and I made a nice one at the end of the tournament last year here.
Yeah, that's great. Jack, let me just ask you. Peter said that you looked relaxed, all four of you out there playing for that money. It was just like a walk in the park. Were you really that relaxed?
Well, I don't know whose park you're walking in, but I'll tell you, it might have been my park, but I think...
There's a minefield. There's a minefield out there.
I'll tell you one thing. There's no... You might get relaxed, but when you get yourself in a position to try and win the skin, I know Arnie, you know, he's in there making a lot of birdies, and I know that he isn't exactly saying, you know,
who cares?
I'm relaxed. Yeah, that's right. He's going after it. I know that, and we all are, too.
Well, thanks a lot, fellas, and good luck tomorrow on the back nine. Now back to Vin.
Okay, Bob, we've had $90,000 won today, $360,000 to be won tomorrow, and Toyota, proud sponsor of the 1985 Skins game, will award this 1986 Toyota Cressida to this year's champion in addition to his Skins prize purse. Who could ask for anything more? And remember, 20%, $90,000, will be going to Junior Golf when the sun sets tomorrow. The Skins game is brought to you by Toyota, who reminds you to get more from life. Buckle up. Who could ask for anything more? By L.A. from Anheuser-Busch, with half the alcohol of our regular beer, sometimes it's the perfect thing to say. By Citizen, the smartest engineering ever strapped to a wrist. By Rancho California, a Kaiser Development community now opening the new frontier. And by the financial professionals at Payne Weber Incorporated. Big day tomorrow, $100,000 at stake on the 10th hole. For Bob Golby and Peter Jacobson, Vin Scully wishing you good day. Great golfers, Jack Nicklaus, Arnold Palmer, Tom Watson, and Fuzzy Zeller met at Bear Creek Golf Club for skins. And at the outset, it looked like a bad day for Arnold Palmer. He had made a great four-iron shot to the green, missed his birdie putt, and shocked the crowd, missing a one-foot putt for par. Jack Nicklaus knocked in a par putt and gratefully picked up a $15,000 skin. Hard times continued for Arnold Palmer on the second hole. His second shot, 186 yards from the green, and he hooked it hard and short left into the rough. It was a 423-yard par four, and Tom Watson, after a splendid drive in the middle of the fairway, had this shot and was equal to the task.
Where that went in? Bad
air. Watson hitting that iron shot within 6 feet of the flagstick.
That would be my guess.
Watson then putting for birdie and picked up the skin, which was worth $15,000. On the fourth hole, after Palmer had barely avoided difficulty, his fortunes did a complete about-face.
Come down.
A five iron. Passing the cup 8 feet away, and from here on, Palmer was to be a factor as he would birdie four of the last six holes. And from 8 feet away, Arnie got his birdie, picked up a skin worth $30,000. Meanwhile, Watson, who had already picked up one skin at two, was ready to make another move at five, a 430-yard par four, when he hits a wedge just about even with the flagstick. Palmer, right back in action once more on six as he picks up a birdie from 9 feet away. And then he had to stand aside because Jack Nicklaus had a shot to have the hole and keep the skin alive. As it happened to Jack several times, he burned the cup and Arnold Palmer had picked up his second skin. Palmer at number eight, the par 371 yards, was aboard as he hit his iron shot about 12 feet past the hole. But Zeller hit to within eight, Watson to 15, and Nicklaus to 20, as the Eagles were really gathering on the par three. Here is Zeller. 8 feet away, inside Arnold.
Thank you.
Watson was putting for birdie, and this being a carryover worth $50,000. Now it looked like Watson was going to be the richest and collect his third skin. But there was someone standing in his way. That's someone named Arnold Palmer. And from 12 feet away, Arnie had the touch to lift the 50 from Watson and keep the skin alive. And so they came to nine, and it was only right that we would have lengthy eagle putts. Palmer from 95 feet away. Just missing. This was a $75,000 hole, and as Palmer missed from 95, Jack Nicklaus took aim from 75 feet for an eagle. Nicklaus just missed and had a tap-in, and now Palmer needed this for a birdie to have the hole, which he did. So moving to the 10th hole, a $100,000 skin awaited the winner. But it was as if we had moved back the hands of time. Arnold Palmer atop the leaderboard with $45,000, pursued by Tom Watson, Jack Nicklaus, and Fuzzy Zeller on the outside looking in. All roads lead to Rome, they said centuries ago. And in golf today, all roads lead to Route 15 in Southern California, and eventually to the Bear Creek Golf Course, a course designed by Jack Nicklaus, who made the trek from North Palm Beach, Florida to get here. For Arnold Palmer, who came from Latrobe, Pennsylvania. From Tom Watson from Mission Hills, Kansas. And Fuzzy Zeller from New Albany, Indiana. They've arrived to see the rolling hills, broad valleys, mountain meadows, running streams that were first seen by the first settlers, the adventurers, and cattlemen who first arrived in the Temecula Valley and the Rancho California area so many years ago. 200-year-old oaks will bear silent witness as we await the start of the great shootout known as Skins. The four adventurers are here playing for $450,000. The Bear Creek Golf Club gives us a magnificent stage for today's drama. Palmer, Nicklaus, Watson, and Zeller in pursuit of the pot of gold. Let's take a look at the hole.
The 555-yard par 5 11th hole is an interesting one. Like the fourth hole that we saw yesterday, this offers you an option off the tee. The average golfer would prefer to play down the left side, making this a three-shot par 5. But I'm sure these great champions will gamble and go down the right side, with a chance to reach the green in two. It's a gamble because you've got to cross the water twice. If you must lay up, you do so here, leaving you a wedge across the water to the pin today, which is cut in the back right of the green, and this is an extremely difficult green to putt.
We'll pick up the action with second shots on the 11th. The 10th hole was rather uneventful. Three pars have the hole, so Arnold Palmer is away, and this will be his second shot for $125,000.
Fine, as hard as I could do it. The only way I could do it.
A particularly foggy area of the golf course.
You can see the water that they're faced with and trying to get the ball over that water onto the green.
Well, he's right at it, isn't he?
Zeller just running across the green, going off into the fringe by about a foot and a half.
Thank you.
Fuzzy wants to get something going quickly here, especially for $125,000.
Jack Nicklaus' drive caught the bunker.
Nicklaus gambled a little bit on the tee shot. He tried to carry it all the way over everything, and he said he caught it a little bit in the neck, and it ended up in the fairway bunker, which is dead. He had to lay up short of the water. He's going to have about an 8-iron into the green on his third shot. Now, Tom Watson is in the driver's seat on this hole. Because he is so long and plays his tee shot from right to left, he's got the best chance to get to the green and get close to the hole.
Too far right.
Tom Watson catching the bunker on the right side. We have not had a winner of a skin since back on the sixth hole, so with carryovers, this 11th hole is worth $125,000. Hi, everybody. I'm Vin Scully. Welcome to the back nine of Skins 85. You might know how it's played. A designated value attached to each hole. If there's not an outright winner, that value is carried over to the next hole. Yesterday, we saw $90,000 of the $450,000 picked up, so it leaves a lot of money, $360,000, remaining today. $90,000 of the total $450,000, however, will be going to Junior Golf, a great contribution from some great players. With us following all the action will be Peter Jacobson. And Peter, even though you've won over $1 million on the tour, I imagine if you were going to bed last night thinking about $360,000 on the table today, it would be kind of a restless night.
Well, I just couldn't help but thinking last year we came to number 18 with a $240,000 putt made by Jack Nicklaus. We could possibly see the same thing today for $360,000. It boggles the mind.
It is a breathtaking idea. Out on the course with the players will be former Masters champion, a winner of 11 tournaments, all right, and that would be Bob Golby. And Bob, what about the back nine?
Well, Vinny, it looks simpler than the front nine, but there's more water, and the greens have more undulation, and the pins are tough today.
And Bob, the winner of the most skins, will also receive a 1986 Toyota Cressida. We'll be back for the third shots on 11 right after this. Eric Nicklaus now, his third shot on the par 5. So Nicklaus, below the hole in 3, has a chance for a birdie 4 to pick up a skin. He hasn't had one, as you can see, since the first hole. Watson won his skin at the second and then came along and picked up one at 5. Arnold Palmer won a double skin or two skins on the fourth hole and another skin at 6, and that's the last one we've seen. It's been carryover time since the seventh hole, and here we are on the 11th. There's the money so far, and as you can see, Palmer picked up a carryover skin at 4 to give him $30,000. And now we advance into 11, and we're really getting into the high-rent district now.
Well, the players are a little bit more formal to each other. The laughing of yesterday is gone, and everybody's kind of sizing each other up. They're looking over their shoulder, checking out to see where they are, how their lie looks, and if they're going to make a birdie or a par.
And in a sense, it seems to add to the drama just to have that veil of fog. It makes it almost an ominous sight as they go down to the wire for a lot of money.
Well, Fuzzy's just off the fringe on the golfer's left side of the green, and he would seem to be in the driver's seat. But with these great players, you have no idea what could happen. Someone may hold out of his traps. Arnold may chip this in. The way he's been playing, he just might do it.
Arnold made an excellent bunker shot to get his par at 10. And we'll see about this shot, his third on the par 5.
He's got to bring it up over that swale that you see right in the middle of the green.
Strong, long, and Palmer has a lengthy putt to try and get birdie. Tom Watson hit his shot in the bunker on the right side of the green, so he's about ready. This will be his third shot.
Last year in the skins game, we watched Tom Watson hit some great bunker shots to save birdies and pars on that backside, which enabled Nicklaus to pick up that big skin on 18, so I look for Tom to hit a good shot here. It looks to be about a 20-yard bunker shot.
He's about 25 yards away, is right, Peter. Good lie. Tom, a wonderful bunker player. Probably one of the real strong points of his game, although he has many. Good-looking shot if it takes the bite, and it did just that. Beautiful shot from Tom Watson here at the 11th hole.
Okay, Watson will eat your lunch out of the bunker. He is one of the best.
Fuzzy's about 22 feet from the flag. Good lie. Has about 3 feet of apron to negotiate. Almost could putt it, but I think the grass is just a little bit long for him. He's going to pitch it. He has a little bit of a knob to negotiate. Once this ball hits the green, it looks like it's going to want to kick to the right.
hear the people in the background screaming for Fuzzy. They want him to get back in the game.
Fuzzy, the only one of the four without a skin, and even as he looks at that makeable birdie putt, he knows he can be caught here at 11. Remember, if there is not an outright winner here at 11, the 12th hole would then become a $150,000 hole.
Jack Nicklaus with the longest birdie putt on this hole. As you remember, he hit it in the fairway bunker off the tee and had to lay up short of the water in two, and he played a short wedge to this position here, putting straight uphill. He's done that a lot. He's run the ball right by the edge of the hole.
Yesterday, perhaps his most frustrating moment was on the sixth, when his birdie putt lipped out and Arnold Palmer picked up the skin with a nine-footer. Now he has to settle for par here at the 11th, with Watson, Zeller, and Palmer still to shoot at birdie. Thinking right now the fact that Fuzzy Zeller, who had a big drive, then his second shot rolled through the green, and from 22 feet he made a wonderful chip just short. So they're almost conceding Zeller's birdie, and one of them has to come up with a birdie to keep the skin alive. Be Palmer who will catch Zeller. Arnold, like Jack Nicklaus, would have to settle for par. So Zeller is very close to his first skin, and what a skin it could be, worth $125,000. And Tom Watson is the one now to try and apply a little pressure and keep the skin away from him.
If I were Fuzzy Zeller, I would not be counting on winning a skin on this hole, because Tom Watson is the best from this distance. I think everybody in the golfing world knows that. Tom Watson seems to relish these situations. He cannot wait to be tested on a 5 or 6 foot putt. This for birdie and to put a little pressure on Fuzzy Zeller.
All right, Watson has applied the thumb screws. Fuzzy Zeller, 1 minute, would be putting to win the skin. Now he has to putt to halve the hole and keep the skin alive. If Fuzzy knocks in this putt, it would then make the 12th hole a par 3, 204-yard hole worth $150,000.
Let him watch that a little bit.
You
don't
want to go 50-50 down the cut there?
You hear Fuzzy talking about splitting the pot. I don't think Tom's going to go for that. He's going to wait till the next hole.
So Fuzzy Zeller and Tom Watson pick up birdies, and it's a carryover to 12 for $150,000. The Skins Game is brought to you by Toyota, who reminds you to get more from life. Carryovers, they move to the 12th hole, which is worth $150,000. Let's take a look at it.
The 12th hole is a par 3, 204 yards long. The prevailing wind is against the players here. They will be hitting anywhere from a 3-iron down to a 1-iron. The green is difficult. It's guarded on the front right by 3 pot bunkers, and if you get your golf ball in there, it's going to be difficult to get a par 3. But today, the pin is placed in the center of the green, and I believe these great players will be shooting right at that pin for a birdie.
Arnold Palmer still has the honors since he won the last skin yesterday on the sixth hole.
This hole can lull you to sleep. It doesn't look that tough from the tee, but it is well bunkered, and the pin today is in a real tough spot.
Arnold is on the green, but as you can hear, he's not too happy with it. A long way from the flag stick.
Bob, I would imagine the players are hitting about a 2 or 3 iron today, aren't they?
Well, I'm up at the green right now, Peter, so I cannot give you the exact club they're hitting, but we know it's got to be a long iron, anywhere from a 1 iron to a 3 iron.
I know during the Pro-Am, the players were hitting 3 irons. Of course, it's a pretty calm day today.
Boy, it's a good-looking shot. It's covering the flag. Now it's drifting a little left of the flag. And I'm telling you, a beautiful-looking golf shot by Watson here at the 12th hole. About 15 feet short and to the left.
I know Tom Watson's been working on his tempo, and I think the key today is not only to keep the ball in play for Tom, but also to keep that tempo slowed down. He has a tendency to get a little quick, snatching the club away from the ball, and he plays his best golf when he evens that tempo out and stays as smooth as he possibly can swing.
Peter, for $150,000, you think you can keep it slow?
They better.
This is Jack's type of shot. He said he's playing everything left to right now, and the big part of the green is to the left. If he can start a little left and drift it in there, he likes to hit them high, and it's a perfect pin placement for his type shot. You think? Boy, right, just about the same distance as Watson, just a little more coming uphill. A little easier putt than Tom's. He's a little more up the valley. Very makeable birdie for Jack Nicklaus.
Fuzzy Zeller now to hit. Everybody knows about his back troubles and the back surgery he had yesterday. When he was done, his back was very sore.
And he is inside.
He's about 12 feet away. He's inside of Watson and Nicklaus.
So Zeller 12 feet away, Nicklaus and Watson 15 feet away, and perhaps someone is away from 150,000. Deathly silence on the 12th green, and understandably so, as all four men are putting on the par three for $150,000.
Arnold can give this one a free run. He's got the other three guys up there putting for birdie, so he's going to give this his best shot.
Come on, Arnie, get up there. Come on. Ring the bell.
Shades of yesterday's ninth when he just missed from 95 feet. Now remember, the 13th hole is worth $35,000 as it stands. If there is not an outright winner at 12, the 13th would then be worth $185,000.
I think we've seen a rebirth in Arnold Palmer's short game. I know it's well chronicled how he's had so much trouble with it over the last 4 or 5 years. But the way he putted yesterday and the way he's rolling it today, he just might be reading his name in the winner's circle on the senior tour in the next couple of years, the way he's putting. Now you've got three putts here, virtually the same distance, the same line. And again, Jack's going first, so he's going to give a little bit of a help to the other two guys, and I know he's not happy about that. On 18 last year, when he won that $240,000, he was the last one to putt.
Wouldn't be a bad one to make, Jackson.
Boy, Bob, they're really grim out there now, aren't they?
They sure are, and like you said earlier, that they're not talking like being as jovial as they were yesterday. They were joking about all the shots. Now they're just grinding and going about their own business. Jack actually has the easier putt of the three, in my mind. He's in a valley, and his putt is definitely looks straight to me. It's about 15 feet straight up the little hill, and the greens are smooth. Very little grain in these greens, Peter. You know the ball. Wherever you start it, that's usually where it stays.
You heard Jack say it's the right center of the hole to his son Jack. Now it's left to Watson.
Never
and
move the other way.
Watson is next from about 15 feet, and then Zeller from 12.
Never came back. 6 feet from the hole, I thought it was the dead center.
As I said, on the last hole, Tom Watson loved these situations.
Inside left there.
He says it inside left. Fuzzy Zeller now has a chance to pick up his first and only skin and listen to the gallery.
Well, Fuzzy's such a great sport. I know everybody wants to see him do well. They know his back's hurting him. And nobody wants to get shut out in this thing.
If he knocks this in, his back won't hurt.
Come on, Fuzzy, no pressure.
What do you think, Buke? One go left, one go right, and I think that's the straight. Huh? Don't you think so? Do I have a straight putt in my putter? I don't know. Thank you, sir. I appreciate you guys showing me the line on that one. I do.
Nice going there, partner.
Thank you, sir. That's good to break the string here. I thought maybe I was in the driver's seat on the last hole, but with Watson playing putting there from that range, it's almost a gimme for him. But I made a very good two here.
Tell me how it feels to putt for $150,000.
Well, I'm going to tell you, my gut is jumping. I'm not going to lie to you. It's a wonderful feeling, but that's what I came here for, is to have the opportunity to do this.
Nice going, partner.
Thank you, Bob.
Is that how much it was?
And we have a lot of money left. There is still $200,000 left on the table as Zeller picked up $150,000.
Entrepreneur. One who assumes the risks of business. Rockwell International managers have the entrepreneurial freedom to move through the maze of business challenges. With advanced technologies and innovative quality products, Rockwell International entrepreneurs get results.
I want you to take a look at the leaderboard. The who's who in small trucks. Toyota. Toyota's the one who's got gas turbo truck power. I guess he's playing through. And Toyota's the one that's got more hauling and pulling power.
Thanks.
You know who's got room to carry the big load? Toyota. So it's pretty clear to me that the who's who knows what's what in trucks.
Who could ask for anything more? Toyota.
Who is the leading money winner on the PGA Tour? Jack Nicklaus? Arnold Palmer? Tom Watson? No, in fact, the answer is charity. 1984 PGA Tour events contributed more than $9 million to a wide variety of charities benefiting people and communities across America. This year, it is estimated that total contributions to deserving groups will surpass $10 million, proving once again that the real leading money winner on the PGA Tour is charity.
Joni Carter's Aurora paint box has caught a smiling Fuzzy Zeller, and for good reason. And with $210,000 left,
Let's take a look at the 13th hole.
13th hole is a par 4, 349 yards in length. We'll probably see a fairway wood off the tee or maybe even a long iron, because accuracy is the key. You've got to avoid the two bunkers that you see on the left and on the right. The long hitters can reach the screen with a driver if they feel up to it. You're only going to be left with a short wedge to the pin, which is cut in the back of the green. And to make a birdie here, you've got to get on top of that big swale that you see right in front of the pin.
Each of the remaining holes were $35,000 apiece. So if we have some carryovers, the money will mount up quickly again. Hooked it in the left bunker.
It was hit so bad.
Low hook to the left.
Who cares? It was worth
it. It reminds me of a bad drive that Gary Player had immediately after knocking in a putt for $150,000. I think the letdown gets to you there.
Yeah, I don't see how you can keep your mind on your game after just making a putt for $150,000.
And as Fuzzy said, who cares?
Who cares?
Arnold out to the right a little bit. Now it's hooking back. It's going to be a nice drive. Perfect drive.
In the trap?
No, short of it.
All right. Pushed it just a touch.
You heard Tom Watson say he wanted a three wood from his caddy, Bruce Edwards.
Out to the right, little same line as Arnold's. Going to be the right side of the fairway. Bunker. Oh, it went through the fairway.
Bunker,
right down the middle. Perfect drive by Jack Nicklaus. So they're away on the 13th hole. The money is piling up and $210,000 still out on the table. Marshals throughout skins are members of the Southern California section of the PGA of America. Arnold Palmer's drive just short of that bunker, and he's away.
There's quite a large swale in the middle of the green. The pin is on top of that little plateau today. But he's got a wedge in his hand, and I don't think they're going to have any problems getting the ball up by the hole.
Good hit.
Good looking shot, just drifting left of the flag. Beautiful shot. So Palmer just a couple of feet away from a birdie on a $35,000 hole.
Who? Who shot it? Mine? Okay.
It's Tom Watson's shot. Watson, you remember, hit a three wood into the bunker.
Hey. Get up, baby.
And the ball checking up on Watson and retreating from the flagstick, rolling back down the swale.
He just did not get that ball up far enough, and you saw it pull back down the swale.
You know, an interesting thought, on a course in which he built, Jack Nicklaus, very close to being shut out. If Palmer didn't miss that one-foot par putt on one, he wouldn't have any skins at all.
I think Jack's a little frustrated. He's putted the ball well. Here he's got a wedge to that pin.
A little left of the flag, but nice-looking golf shot, drifting back now.
Good shot. I think all the air has been let out of that pressure balloon with that $150,000 putt.
However, since this is worth $35,000 and each hole is worth $35,000, it'll pile right up again almost immediately. Good shot out of the bunker by Fuzzy. Directly at the flag. It's going to have to hurry to get up that hill.
Ooh, didn't get it up the hump.
Nuts.
Palmer is closest to a birdie putt right now, so he has a chance. Talking about chance and talking about skins, we had a chance to chat with Jack Nicklaus. Jack Nicklaus has changed considerably and changed for the better. The Jack Nicklaus of 1960 was heavy, crew cut, and yet you tampered with that excellence and changed your entire look. Wasn't that a risk?
Well, it certainly wasn't on purpose. It just happened then. I went, in my first 7 years on the tour, to right around somewhere fluctuating between 2.5 and 2.15, which is about what I was in 1960 also. And that was 1969. I decided to lose weight. Yeah, my look changed, obviously. I looked, I went from, you know, baggy pants and extra large shirts to little trimmer look, but you know, times changed with that. The hairstyles changed and everything else. It wasn't a conscious effort to do something. I did it for health reasons.
Well, weren't you afraid that that would affect your game?
I thought about it when I was doing it. I went on my diet. It took me about 3 weeks to lose my weight. I went to Silverado for the first tournament that I played after I lost weight. I won that tournament. I went to Las Vegas the next week, won that tournament. Went to Hawaii the next week, and I finished second. So I didn't really worry about my game after that. That didn't really bother me. From then on, I knew that probably I'd done the right thing, and I should have done it probably 10 years earlier.
All four on the green now in two on this par four, and Watson is away for birdie. $35,000 hole.
No. You see that ball pull off to the left there? You can't see the hump on television, but it's quite a large undulation, and it's a very difficult putt Tom had.
Palmer is closest to the cup, so now Zeller is ready to take a shot. 35. It'll pile right up again almost immediately. Zeller's drive caught the bunker, and this was his second shot.
Ooh, I didn't get it up the hump.
Nuts. Yep.
Shoot. Didn't get it over there far enough.
I'm sure Arnold's standing over on the side with his back to all of this, not wanting to watch anybody.
Well, Zeller and Watson have missed the birdie. It's up to Nicklaus. And, of course, Jack is thinking about Palmer's chances of making his birdie. Here's how Jack got here from the middle of the fairway, 90-some-odd yards away.
Get out.
Is that much, is it? Yeah. And Palmer just waiting for the opportunity to get a birdie and perhaps a $35,000 skin. What has made skins so interesting since the first hole? So many times we had the head-to-head duel between Nicklaus and Palmer.
Just like in the past.
Cue up the music, seems like old time.
Now, Jack's been rolling the ball very well the past 2 days, and I know he wants to make this one very badly. Hit a good putt.
Bold and long, so now the door is wide open for Arnold Palmer.
That falls away, isn't it? Well, I don't care. I think you're away, Fudd. You want a putt?
Well, not really, but I will.
Zeller is away, but he's putting for par, so Arnie can just back off and wait.
I don't think watching Fuzzy's putt here is going to help Arnold at all. It's at a different angle, and I think Arnold would be best to keep his eyes off this putt and concentrate on his own.
Thank you.
That's easy when those don't mean a thing.
Fuzzy, with $150,000 in his wallet, thanks to the 12th hole, has a much more relaxed air about him. Meanwhile, a determined Palmer looking for a skin worth $35,000.
I can see y'all shadow there, Tom, please.
Now, don't forget, this is like putting to win a tournament. The pressure is right on this putt.
Had picked up skins at four and six on the front nine, picks up a $35,000 skin at 13, and we'll move on to the 14th hole.
Five worth $35,000.
Palmer has won $80,000 so far in skins this year.
Almost a bad line of fairways he had in the rough.
Do what?
I almost had a bad line of fairways he had in the bunker.
Here's another look at that shot by Palmer.
When he made contact, that ball barely trickled out of there. That's a tough shot. Very tough position to be in when you're playing for skins.
Fuzzy Zeller was only 53 yards from the flagstick, and he didn't like the shot because with wet grass, he had to finesse it in taking a nice full shot. And he ran it by the cup. Fuzzy was shut out yesterday, you might remember, but boy, did he explode in the 12th hole when he knocked in a 12-footer for $150,000. This one now for $35,000. Yeah. I once heard a caddy say, that ball's afraid of the dark.
I think the hole moved on that one.
Oh, you devil, you.
Now Watson, just watching Palmer, who's away, and Palmer is putting for par.
Goodbye.
I thought I had it. No.
Well, we've got the door open, Tom Watson. I've said it again and again, but these are the situations that Tom Watson loves. He's been in this situation so many times with putts like this to win golf tournaments. And this is just to win a measly $35,000.
Well, he had a 6-foot birdie putt on two for a skin worth $15,000. Then he had a birdie at five for a $15,000 skin. And now it's his first chance since then to pick up another.
Notice Watson, he's very steady over the putt. He's got a very good grip on the putter. Strikes the ball very solid. Nope.
No. Watson needed that par to have the hole with Fuzzy Zeller. That makes it a carryover, and the 15th hole will be worth $70,000. Let's take a look at it.
The 15th hole is a straightaway par 4, 412 yards in length. The players shoot from an elevated tee across this barranca and a huge fairway bunker about 220 yards out from the tee. It's such a wide fairway that it gives the players a chance to really bust it off the tee to get out as far as they possibly can. Once in the landing area here, they'll be hitting a 4 or 5 iron second shot to the green, which is elevated, and the pin is in the back of the green today, and I would say that a birdie will win a skin here.
The 15th hole is worth $70,000 because Fuzzy Zeller's birdie putt missed by an inch. Arnold Palmer, who won the last skin at 13, has the honors.
This is probably the widest driving area on the golf course. There's so much fairway out there. These guys are really going to be trying to pop it.
So good, but it's not so bad either.
You can see from behind the green how wide that fairway is. It's about 50 yards in length from the left to the right side.
But he hit a good solid drive, a little left. Same line as Arnold, only a little longer, and went through the fairway. There's a little neck that comes out of rough up there, and he went through the fairway into that neck.
I said earlier that Fuzzy's back was hurting him last night, and it really was, but it looks like it's loosened up. I think the sun has helped him quite a bit.
Took his sweater off.
No.
Tom on the same, was hooking also a little bit more, though, to the left and up into the bank in the rough.
I can't help but think, but Tom Watson is extremely frustrated at this point. He's hit the ball well, he's putted well, he just hasn't been able to get the ball in the hole. For the big money now. He's got some money, so I know he's not going to go home that upset.
Such is life, isn't it, huh?
That's the way it is.
That's the way it is.
I can still hit it, that's...
Yeah.
Jack Nicklaus made a little change in his game a little while back. He's been trying to play from right to left. And his wife, Barbara, said, Jack, you know, you were fairly successful playing left to right, so why don't you get back to your game? And he has.
Beautiful drive, and big left to right, down to right center, and long.
Not all that bad.
So Palmer and Nicklaus in the fairway, Watson on the bank in the rough, and Zeller through the fairway in the rough. I'm going to play a little word association and just get your quick comment. Jack Nicklaus.
Well, what can I say? I don't think there's a word to describe him. Tremendous, great. He's in that category.
You've been paired with him many times?
And yes, I have. I've been fortunate to play with Jack, Arnold, and Tom. He's just a tremendous human being, also off the golf course, which I think is a big key to all three, to the other three guys that I'm playing with this week.
Arnold Palmer.
Golf. I'll just give you that word. I think he's done... He and Jack both have done for golf something that I don't think anybody else would ever come close to.
Tom Watson.
Tom Watson put, as a human being on a golf course, guts. He is a gutsy player. There's never a shot that Tom Watson cannot play on the golf course.
Fuzzy Zeller suddenly moves in to play skins with three other illustrious golfers. Will we see the happy-go-lucky, talkative, laughing and scratching Frank Urban Zeller? Or, as the skins begin to mount and the money begins to mount, do you think you will change?
I hope not. You know, that's like going up the river with your paddles and all of a sudden dropping them and still trying to go up. No, I've got to go with what got me here, and that's talking and being happy-go-lucky. Now, I do have a few tricks in the bag for these guys if the time presents itself. But if it doesn't, then I won't use them. But if it does present itself, I will bring them out for them.
The 14th hole was a carryover, so this 15th hole is worth $70,000. Nicklaus with a big drive. Yeah. Palmer in the fairway, and Palmer is away.
Arnold Palmer with a 3-iron.
Oh, be right.
Boy,
get all the way
good.
Back there.
Little left of the flag, but a good-looking shot.
Oh, great shot.
Ran a little to the back edge of the green, though, but it was a good-looking shot with a 3-iron for Arnold.
Caught it a little thin. I tried to catch it clean, and I caught it a little thin. How far is that pin from the back?
Yeah. Remember, Tom Watson's drive went up the bank, and he's in the rough. Very tough shot. Again, the ball below. And 172 yards away.
6-iron.
A familiar spot for Watson. He's not the straightest driver on tour, and he spends a lot of time in the rough, but he knows how to play from here.
A little bit of a flyer. He's going to play for it to jump out that wet grass.
No, it's too far.
He had a good-looking shot. It's right in line with the flag.
Not bad, though. The back edge.
Boy, that ball had a lot of spin on it coming out of that rough.
He really knows how to play those iron shots.
Thank you.
You can see the frustration on his face. I know he's not happy with what's going on right now.
Long time between skins. And, of course, for Jack, the longest. His only skin on number one.
600. Six iron with a good lie for Jack Nicklaus,
right, right in line with the right short distance.
Fuzzy Zeller, remember, hit his drive through the fairway into the rough.
Seven iron with a flying lie. Another good-looking shot, right in line with the flag, if it's long enough. Good shot.
So we'll wait for the third shots, and we'll spend that time with a little visit with Jack Nicklaus.
What far short is that? That can't be that short.
Yeah.
Winning is synonymous with Nicklaus, and we talked about changes, the changes physically, the changes as you matured as a man, as a golfer. One other thing, the big change in the life of Jack Nicklaus, the golfer, you went from... Well, let's face it, almost the villain.
Sure.
You went from villain to hero. That must have been a very, very heavy load in the early days to be considered a usurper of the crown. I can't say Cassius with a lean and hungry look because you looked the other way. But you were definitely
a
threat.
That wasn't very nice.
but you were a villain.
Sure. I go back and look at the films, too. I said, how could I root for him either, you know? When I came along, obviously Arnold was playing very well, and I'd played a lot of amateur golf, or as an amateur, I played not a lot, but I played several times with Arnold, and before I turned pro. And when I was coming, I looked at Arnold as the head guy in the game. But I didn't believe that I couldn't beat him. Just like he didn't, anywhere he came along, he thought he could beat everybody else too. I mean, that's the feeling you have to have, I think, anyway. And so my first few years on the tour, I played, with blinders on. And people say, Jack, how about the crowd at Oakmont? Good gracious, I mean, playing in Arnold's backyard. I said, what crowd? I never heard him. Didn't pay attention to me. I had my mind set on what I was going to do. So to a large extent, I never really suffered from that situation until maybe two or three years later when I started reading papers. I don't pay attention to articles, and I really still don't. All you do is pick up an article, all you do is find something wrong, and you're going to get mad at it. So I sort of take a policy not to really pay a whole lot of attention to it. Golf's a funny game. It's the only game where, not the only game, but where the fans root generally for the guy who is the best player. Most sports, you like to see the underdog win. But in most sports, remember, to be the winner in that sport, you win 80 or 90% of the time. In golf, if you win 10 or 15% of the time, you're the top player.
And as he's ready to go into his 25th year, he's still battling Arnold Palmer. And vice versa.
Arnold had a putt. It was straight downhill there, and he really...
I'm going to leave it short.
I don't think he could have left it short. He just gave it the best run he had, try to make a three, because these other guys all have pretty good putts at him.
I don't know how that was going to come out of there. Oh, yeah.
You heard Fuzzy say that he thinks his putt is going to the right. Putting straight uphill.
He watched Arnold's putt come down that hill. He knows his is going to the right because Arnold went left.
$70,000. Maybe.
He's loosened up, hasn't he?
Thank you. Enjoy your putting strokes.
Good putt.
Thank you, sir.
He's a good sport.
He's pretty straight.
Watson now trying to catch Zeller, keep the skin alive, and make the 16th hole $105,000.
Watson trying to be the spoiler, trying to take that money right out of Fuzzy's pocket. Much like Arnold did to him yesterday on number 8.
Short. Or one down. I thought it was an idea.
See if I left the short. And that hill. My God.
Nothing bothers Tom Watson more than leaving a putt short.
Zeller and Watson birdied 11 to force it into a carryover, but not this time. It's up to Nicklaus to make this a carryover. Fuzzy picks up 70 and has now won $220,000. Hugs and kisses, and we'll move on to a $35,000 16th hole. The 16th hole is a par 3, 206 yards long. A beautiful hole from an elevated tee to a large green. It's guarded on the left front by a big gaping bunker and on the right side by a large old oak tree. The green looks simple, but there's a 5-foot knob in the center of it, and the pin is placed up on top of it. Even though it looks easy, a par 3 is going to be a good score here. It is so interesting that Fuzzy Zeller, who was shut out yesterday, the only one to be on the outside, and did not do anything on 10 and 11, wound up with a $150,000 skin on 12, a $70,000 skin on 15, and his saddle bag is bursting with $220,000.
Oh, nice shot. Hit the world for me, Bob.
That is way left.
Hit the world for me, ball, is what he said.
Well, that's the second time you've seen Fuzzy do that. On number 13, after that big skin, on number 12, he hooked it left in the bunker. He picks up 70,000 there and then hits a bad shot.
The trees.
I think Fuzzy's problem yesterday was experience. The other three guys had played 2 years in a row, and Fuzzy, I think, had a problem maybe feeling like he didn't belong. But he's such a good sport. He didn't say a thing. He played his golf game, and here he is today, and he's leading the whole pack.
3 iron for Arnold. Started at the flag, drifting slightly to the left, but it's a good-looking golf shot. About hole high, about 15, 18 feet.
Remember, this hole is for $35,000. There's still $105,000 to be picked up.
Oh, there's a pretty one.
4 iron for Watson. Way to the right. Into the tree. Into the gallery.
Well, if he goes over there, Zeller can give him change for a 10.
Jack so far has been a little bit snake-bitten with those two putts to tie the skins yesterday on number 6. Today on 15, hitting the edge of the cup and lipping it out. He's rolled the ball well, but nothing's gone in for him yet.
4 iron left center of the green, staying out to the left.
Cut it.
Yeah. We're on the surface.
We'll be coming back with more skins, and as we leave for the moment, we'll take a look at the magic of Joni Carter and the Aurora paint box. A lovely picture. Watson hit a four iron into the trees right of the green. Jack Nicklaus barely got on the green. Fuzzy Zeller was in the trees, and a three iron from Arnold Palmer got him to about 18 feet from the cup. So he's putting for birdie. No birdies at 16. In fact, Fuzzy Zeller picked up after a bogey to spend some time with his investment counselor. This was Tom Watson a few moments ago after the four iron hit the trees. It was his chip.
He had to try to bump it into that hill and run it up on top.
I tell you what.
It was a beautiful shot. About 7 feet.
Thank you.
So Watson will putt for par first. Zeller out of the hole.
You heard Watson ask Jack if he thought he could make it, and Jack said, Tom, don't wait for me. Jack does not have a gimme, and you've got to keep Palmer honest.
So Watson will bogey 16. He will not be able to put any pressure on Palmer. And once again, for the umpteenth time, it's a battle between Nicklaus and Palmer.
This is one of the tougher greens on the golf course to putt, and Jack was putting from the golfer's left, the fringe coming through that little swale up to the pin. He had about a 40-foot putt. He left it just about 2 feet short, putting for a par.
Okay.
All right, Nicklaus gets his par at 16, so that catches Palmer to have the hole, and it makes the 17th hole worth $70,000.
The 17th hole is 426 yards in length, a dogleg left par 4. It favors a draw off the tee, but I'm sure at this point with the big money online, these players will take it anywhere in the fairway. The left side is preferable, and once you get there, you're going to be faced with an 8 or a 9 iron second shot to the pin, which is cut in the far right of the green. It's guarded in front by a huge grass bunker, and I would say you're going to need a birdie here to win a skin.
So for the fourth time on the back nine in skins, we have a carryover hole, and this 17th worth $70,000. Zeller with the skin at 15 still has the honors.
Zeller with the driver down the left side. Good and solid. A little more hook than he won it, though.
I have definitely got the over-the-top working well this week.
I think it's far enough that it's all right.
And Brian.
This is one of the tighter driving holes on the golf course. You've got to play a little bit of a draw off the tee. Fuzzy just turned it over a little too much.
Good drive, little left center for Arnold. A good solid long. That's the best of the day for Arnold Palmer.
Oh, no, stay in the fairway. Stay in the fairway.
Hate to tell you, Arnold, that it did not cut the rough.
Right center, hooking back. Good solid drive. Nice drive.
It's pretty flight.
To the fairway and straight.
Start down left, drifting back to the right. Good solid drive.
So Nicklaus and Watson in the fairway, Zeller off on the left side, and Palmer in the rough. We'll be back. It's run 17 coming up with $70,000. Skin waiting for the winner. Nicklaus in the fairway, Watson down the left side with a big drive, and here's Arnold Palmer.
He has a 6-iron, Vinny. A little bit of a flying lie, 160 yards.
Well,
he pulled it bad over towards that left bunker, left of the green, and
that was not a good spot.
Jack, the next player.
Didn't get at it.
64?
Yep.
One's coming down her back a little bit now. Starting up. Down on the rough.
Pin today cut on the right side of the green. This is set up perfect for Jack's bread and butter shot. A little left to right fade from the center of the green working toward the pin on the right.
Left center of the green. It's staying there.
Got there.
We'd like to use this moment to thank all the good folks at Bear Creek for the wonderful time they have given us, to Bob Hayward, the tournament director, general manager of Bear Creek, vice president Jack Nicklaus, club management, Dave McKee, the head golf professional at Bear Creek, Larry O'Brien, the media relations man, and Mike Koopman, green superintendent of Bear Creek.
Tom Watson's a bit grim. He wants to win a skin.
That's an 8-iron. Peter, and it's left to its center of the green, left of the pin.
Right, right there. Hang on, sir. Sir, we got one more.
The Skins Game is brought to you by USF&G. All across this country, USF&G protects your business, home, auto, and life. USF&G covers the USA. By L.A. from Anheuser-Busch. With half the alcohol of our regular beer, sometimes it's the perfect thing to say. By National Car Rental, you deserve national attention. By the financial professionals at Payne Weber Incorporated. And by Rancho California, a Kaiser development community now opening the new frontier. We'll be right back. I'm about 40 feet away. Jack Nicklaus putting for birdie and for $70,000. Arnold Palmer, who left a shot in the bunker, has picked up. So it is really a battle now between Nicklaus and Watson.
His putt will go left the last 6 or 8 feet. It'll break left. Good putt from that angle. He had a tough knob in front of him, about a 3-foot rise, and then sort of down to a sloping pin placement.
Boy, he's had enough of those, and the one that really haunted him was the 12th hole when he missed by an inch to have a $150,000 skin, eventually won by Zeller.
But no cigars.
He's putted the ball extremely well, but he just hasn't been able to find the cup.
Even though Jack has about a 3-footer, it's still not a gimme, and Fuzzy has about a 20-footer.
Here was Fuzzy's shot, pretty close to the green. Again, another finesse shot. It bothered him earlier.
Knuckleball. Ball turn.
Tom's putt's about 12 feet.
Here we've got the leading money winner, $220,000 in the bank. He picked up once yesterday, picked up twice today, and he was just about
completely out of the hole here, so that's the comfort of the skins game.
Tom did get a look-see at Fuzzy's putt. It was basically on the same line. It looked like it worked slightly to the left.
Watson has won two skins, both yesterday on the second hole and on the fifth, so he's gone a long time without a skin.
Work a lot right. I figured it'd do. Darn it.
Darn it would be the understatement considering the prize money. This putt, of course, for Nicklaus is for par to have the hole with Watson and then force another carryover. So the 18th hole would be worth $105,000. Big putt.
You know, even though we've seen Jack make most of these throughout his career, his ball has not been finding the center of that cup, so I'm sure he's
it goes
concerned.
Left or right. That's a nice position to be in, isn't it?
What are the treats?
This slope coming here, but you can also see this slope
right
coming here.
Fired right
here. I'm going to do much of anything. Or I'm going to try to hit it.
One of the treats we've had is listening to the players talk to their caddies the last 2 days, and I know everybody at home always wonders what they say.
And that's the way it's been throughout skins for Jack Nicklaus.
He'd do it for Watson. He wouldn't do it for
right.
You can hear Arnold Palmer. He'll do it for Watson. He won't do it for me. And a grinning Watson has walked away, not only dodging a bullet, but he has picked up $70,000 to give him $100,000. When you're looking for $35,000, we move to the 18th hole, a par four. We can take a look at it.
The 18th hole is a par four, 430 yards long. This is my favorite hole here at Bear Creek because they give you plenty of room off of the tee. They almost sucker you into trying to get into that lake. In other words, you're going to drive down to this point. You're going to need a 5 or 6 iron, for the shorter hitters a 4 iron, to clear this lake and reach this green. The green is large. Today the pin is placed in the center rear of the green, and I think we're going to see a birdie here today.
In looking back, you realize that Tom Watson won a $70,000 skin with a par. All of the other skins were picked up with birdies.
Very wide driving area. Worth $35,000, the 18th hole.
Going way to the right. Down along the out of bounds. Could be out of bounds. Going to hit out of bounds. Looks like it went past the out of bounds.
I don't know if it's in bounds or not.
I think it's all right.
Okay, right hip. Try to get through this one here, just the heck of it.
There you go.
Yeah, that's a little better.
Perfect tee shot from Fuzzy Zeller.
Left center, good drive for Arnold. Solid hit. Perfect position. Got the good angle coming across that lake.